checking generators and stocking up on fuel. Shelters like this one, called Points on Invincibility, are providing support in the wake of Russia's massive air attack. They are places for Ukrainians to power up and more.
After the attack, power outages started at 9 a.m. Then the electricity appeared for 20 minutes. Now it's evening, but there is still no light.
Many visited this Invincibility center in the town of Gostomel in the Kyiv region.
The light was turned off unexpectedly. People did not have time to prepare. Some came to us for hot water, some to work or charge gadgets.
According to Ukrainian Prime Minister Denis Shmyhal, the Russian attacks affected at least 15 regions. The Ukrainian military said Russia primarily targeted the energy infrastructure.
The situation in the energy sector remains difficult. Russia attacked energy distribution and transmission systems, but energy experts know how to repair the damage. This is no longer the despair as in 2022, when the shelling began.
Вони знають, що робити в тому випадку, коли.
Other cities, like Zhytomyr, experience water supply problems.
Декілька ракет зайшли по енергетичній інфраструктурі міста.
Several rockets hit the energy infrastructure and electricity completely disappeared. The water supply company switched to generators. We could provide water two or three times a day for 2 to 3 hours. Now the situation has improved, but the amount of electricity is minimal.
Три рази на добу по 2-3 години.
The Russian attack also caused train delays.
Зараз ми працюємо над тим, щоб
we are currently working to ensure that trains, which are currently delayed by 5 to 7 hours, will go according to their schedule on their way back. But we already understand that at least 3 such trains will leave with a delay.
According to a state-owned electricity operator, Ukrenergo, the attack on August 26th was the 9th to hit the country's energy infrastructure. Ukrainian officials have not disclosed the total scale of damage caused by the Russian strikes. Леся Бакалець, VOA News.